Let us study a very important concept about radioactive beta emission, that is apparent violation of conservation laws and beta decay. It is observed that during beta decay, when it was discovered, the fundamental laws are not being followed, or you can say when mathematically beta decay was analyzed based on experimental values, conservation laws does not hold. So, let's see how this was explained. When we talk about a beta decay, if there is a parent nucleus X, one is decays to the daughter nucleus Y and a beta particle. It was observed the very first thing is this Y recoils with some kinetic energy KY, and beta particle also carries some energy, but not in opposite direction, in some other direction with the K beta. And in various experiments, it was observed that Y was moving with same energy, but beta was not having same energy. So, if we talk about the fundamental laws, the very first is a law of conservation of energy. Then it was observed that Q value of beta decay for a given reaction is constant, and kinetic energy of the daughter nucleus Y is also constant in almost all cases, but when we talk about kinetic energy of beta particle, this is varying in different cases. So, this was a mystery here, and it was also considered that KY plus K beta, when it is calculated, it was less than the Q value of a reaction, and even this is not a constant. So, this was a confusion over here that why the energy conservation law is not holding true, because whatever amount of energy is released, it must be shared between the two particles as kinetic energy. So, it was assumed that some other particle or radiations should also be there in the summation, but practically it was not discovered. The second law was the law of conservation of linear momentum, about which with this figure which I have drawn, you can see if this nuclei X was at rest, on decaying it into Y and beta, if Y is moving in a direction and if no other particle is emitted, this beta must move in the direction opposite to it. So, practically it should be X which transforms to Y and beta. Under ideal situation, these two move away from each other in any direction such that the total momentum will remain zero. But this is not the practical case. Actually, it happens like this. So, we can say that linear momentum conservation will not be true over here. And you can see in this also, it is apparent that some other particle is emitted in other direction, then only it can be conserved. But this was not detected. This particle which we are talking about was not detected practically. So, again, this was considered that it is not holding. And the third law was a law of conservation of angular momentum. It is considered that in a beta decay, a nucleon is transformed into two nucleons. Like if we talk about beta minus decay 0 and 1 transformed to 1p1 plus minus 1e0. Or in other cases also, there are three nucleons involved, one transformed to 2 or 2 transformed to 1, like in K capture. So inside the nucleus, it is considered that every nucleon, it is well proven that every nucleon has some spin angular momentum, and spin angular momentum of a nucleon inside the nucleus is given as plus minus half h over 2 pi. Plus minus corresponds to either clockwise or anticlockwise spin direction. So, its magnitude is half h over 2 pi over the other sign. So, if a neutron decays to a proton and an electron, here we can see the neutron would be having angular, spin angular momentum plus minus half h over 2 pi. And if it transforms to a proton and another electron, which is also a nucleon in this case. So these two must also carry plus minus half h over 2 pi. And plus minus half h over 2 pi spin angular momentum. So before the reaction, the total spin angular momentum of this neutron was this, but after decay, the spin angular momentum would become plus minus h over 2 pi or 0. If both are considered with same sign, it will be plus minus h over 2 pi, and if these are taken with the opposite sign, this will be 0. So here we can see that in this beta emission, the spin angular momentum will not remain conserved, and as no external torque is there, angular momentum must remain conserved. So these are the three fundamental laws which were assumed that these are not holding true in case of beta emission. But later it was explained in a different way that we'll study in coming sections.